Merry Christmas. It's almost here. Christmas vacation is almost here, and Christmas right behind it. So I'm sure we're all very excited. We're excited to have our fifth graders leading in our Christmas chapel today. So thank you to Mrs. Volpe and Mrs. Westenberg and leading their kids. I know they're excited to get up here and share with us today and a special message on Christmas. But we have a bunch of birthdays and some other recognitions we want to do before we get started this morning. So we're going to start with birthdays, and we want you to all be patient, but we want to recognize all of these kids as they have their birthday this week and those that would be celebrating over Christmas break. So we have over 30 birthdays to do today. So as we come up, we're going to kind of try to keep it moving. And if you're in the first round of birthdays this year, like in the coming weeks, I want to have you stand on the top stage, and then my half birthdays, you'll stand on the lower stage. And Mrs. Woodford and Miss Beckermeyer will try not to mess it all up. So, all right, birthdays this week in second grade, Mrs. Benke's class, Reed Somerville. In seventh grade, Mrs. Overall's class, Lily Tuttle. In Mrs. Volpe's fifth grade class, Caleb Ball. In Mrs. Lewis's seventh grade class, Aubrey Campbell. Mrs. Westenberg's fifth grade class, Bailey Hasselbring. In Miss Beckermeyer's eighth grade class, Amelia Volpe. In Mrs. Volpe's fifth grade class, Caleb Stephens. In Miss Zakur's fourth grade class, Grace Martin. In Mrs. Wessenberg's fifth grade class, Carter Andes. In Mrs. Tucker's second grade class, Autumn McDonald Cole. In Mrs. Holton's sixth grade class, Reese Dietz. In Mrs. Zintek's sixth grade class, Royce Dietz. In Miss Beckermeyer's eighth grade class, Faye Novinsky. In Mrs. Moore's kindergarten class, Shay Dory. In Mrs. Westenberg's fifth grade class, Claire Benchesky. In Mrs. Benke's second grade class, Michael Coliani. In first grade, Mrs. Massow's class, Sophia Paleo. And also in first grade, Mrs. Massow's class, Philip Lee. Also celebrating birthdays from our faculty and staff, Mrs. Massow had a birthday this week. Mrs. Howard is going to have a birthday in January 1, and Mrs. Jolly's birthday is January 1, so make sure you say happy birthday. And we have a bunch of half birthdays as well, so let me go through those. In Mrs. Massow's first grade class, Leo Murillo, half birthday. Mrs. Volpe's fifth grade class, Greta Keys. Miss Osaki's fourth grade class, Andre Doris. Mrs. Massow's first grade class, Harper Hansen. In Mrs. Benke's second grade class, Vivian Busness. Mrs. Wessenberg's fifth grade class, Hudson Dory. Mrs. Massow's first grade class, Sophia Jesse. And Mrs. Overall's seventh grade class, Sophia Freund. And in seventh grade, in Mrs. Overall's class, Sarah Freund. In Mrs. Volpe's fifth grade class, Reagan Little. In Mrs. Jolly's first grade class, Kenzie Pichasinski. In Ms. Beckermeyer's eighth grade class, Quinn Schiffbauer. In Ms. Osaki's fourth grade class, Noah Danielson. In Mrs. Novinsky's kindergarten class, Robbie Stegg. In Mrs. Novinsky's kindergarten class, Jade Weaver. And in Mrs. Westenberg's fifth grade class, Carter Darnell. And if you get a chance, I know she's sick today, but Mrs. Rasmussen has a half birthday on Christmas Day. So make sure you have happy birthday to Mrs. Rasmussen. All right, I think we got everybody. It's a big group. Let's sing happy birthday to all of them together, all right? Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. God bless you and keep you. Happy birthday to you. All right, hope you guys have an awesome birthday or a half birthday. You guys can make your way back to your seats carefully. Christmas presents and birthday presents, how fun, all in the same week. Well, I wanted to take just a moment to recognize a cool group of people that represented Trinity Christian very, very well just a couple Saturdays ago. I don't know if Mr. Hayward has a picture to throw up there. This is our robotics team. If you're on the robotics team, could you stand right now so we can recognize you and see you all? So two Saturdays ago, you guys can stay standing while I talk about you just for a few seconds. Our robotics team represented us at Oswego High School. We were thankful that the competition was local this year. A lot more people were able to attend, and even Mrs. Woodford and I had a chance to go and see it in action, and these guys were doing some amazing stuff here at the robotics competition. Mrs. McBride and Miss Osaki were our leaders there, so we thank them for their hard work and all the volunteers that put in time and effort there. You can see all the parents that are involved with these kids as well. But Mrs. McBride was very proud of them. They did some excellent work and all improved on scores from the year before. And we almost had a team that made it into the top amount of teams to go on to the next competition, but they fell just a little short. But they all worked really hard. It was a long day. They got there before 8 a.m. and didn't go home till almost 4 p.m. So it was a long tournament day, but it was fun to see them in action. And we just want to give a round of applause to our robotics squad for a great job. Well done. Thank you, robotics team. And thank you, Mrs. McBride and Ms. Osaki, for your efforts with them. You guys can be seated. We're so thankful for representing Trinity so well in front of so many other schools. Excellent work. Well, at this time, we are going to get rolling with our chapel and our pledges. So today we have the honor of two Bible holders, Mr. Damani Weathers and Mr. Landon Esquivel. If you guys would come up, Landon and Damani, come on up to the stage. And let's all stand with these boys as we put our hands over our hearts. And we will begin with our pledge to the American flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands. One Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again, with life and liberty for all who believe. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its hearts, my heart, and it might not sin against God. And our verse, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. John 14, verse 6. And I'm sure we're going to be talking about that today with our Savior Jesus Christ being born to us on Christmas Day. And I hope you guys keep that in the center of your heart as you go through this Christmas season. And at this time, I'm going to turn it over to our fifth graders. And I know Bailey is going to come up and lead us in a prayer. And our fifth graders are going to lead.
Dear Lord, thank you for bringing us here today. Help us to have a great chapel. Let us glorify you, Lord, with the songs we are about to sing. And for all the kids that will be on stage, that you will calm their nerves. We ask that everybody here today learns more about how Jesus came on Christmas to save us. Amen.
Go tell it on the mountain, the one that we've been waiting for, the King of our salvation, born on this day, our Savior Christ the Lord. Go tell it. king to see, power up a pom pom. Our finest gifts we bring, power up a pom pom. To lay before the king, power up a pom pom. Rump a pom pom, rump a pom pom. So to honor him, pa rump a pom pom. When we came.
Sky. It's the same that appeared and the wise men revered when hope was born this night. Out upon the snowy fields, there's a silent peace that heals, and it echoes the grace of our Savior's embrace, because hope was born this night. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill toward men. Let all of the world sing the chorus of joy, because hope was born this night. I can hear the Christmas bells ring as softly church choirs sing. It's the song used to praise the Ancient of Days when hope was born this night.
Please welcome Pastor Volpe from Parker Road Bible Church in Mokena.
Well, good morning. Great job, fifth grade. Well, as Aubrey mentioned, my name's Pastor Frank Volpe. I'm from Parker Road Bible Church, and you may know my wife, Mrs. Volpe, fifth grade teacher, and also Amelia in eighth grade. She's my daughter. Nathan in sixth grade is my son. I've had two boys who've graduated from Trinity that are in high school now, a senior and a junior, Joel and Luke, and we love Trinity. We're grateful for the staff here, for all the teachers, and it's great to be here. Thank you for having me to celebrate Christmas with you. I thought we'd start out today with a game, and so we're going to have a good, healthy competition. How about that? We're going to have Mrs. Volpe's class against Mrs. Westenberg's class. So we're going to have two teams, and so we're going to have the red team, and that's going to be Mrs. Westenberg's, her two teammates, and that's going to be Ava and Hudson. Ava and Hudson, can you come up front? And then the green team is Mrs. Volpe's class, and that's going to be Caleb and Maya. I'm going to explain the rules of the game here in a minute. So we have, again, Ava and Hudson are the red team. Can we cheer for the red team? And then we have Caleb and Maya, who are the green team. Can we cheer for the green team? All right, this is what we're going to do. We know at Christmas time we get presents, right? So what they're going to do, we're going to have two designated present openers, okay? You guys are going to open those presents as fast as you can, just like it's Christmas morning, right? And then we're going to have, you guys are going to take the presents and you're going to go find the place where the present goes and put it in its place, okay? So you're going to want to do that as quick as you can, okay? All right, get ready. Get ready to open those presents. Ready, set, go! Let's cheer them on, guys. Looks like Caleb's out in front. Cheer him on, cheer him on. Uh-oh, near collision. Oh, there's a fumble. Let's go, you're running out of time. There's one more present. There's one more present. Hurry. Hurry. Hurry up. Put it in its place. Put it in its place. What's the present? It's baby Jesus. Whoop. There's no place. All right, guys, thank you. There was no place. There was no place for Jesus. There's a place for all the rest of them, but no place for Jesus. Good job, guys. Good job. Thank you for helping. Actually, I have a prize for you. In the spirit of 21st century America, everybody gets a prize, all right? Good job. Well, there was a place for the little planes for Christmas vacations. There were places for Santa. There were places for elves. There were places for new iPhones and new gaming systems. There were places for new clothes and new shoes and new sports equipment and even for a football game. But how could we forget a place for Jesus? How could we forget a place for Jesus? Yeah, there was no place for Jesus. There was no place for Jesus. Did you know that there was no place on Christmas night for Jesus either in the inn? Let me read you a passage. So this is what it says. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem to the town of David because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed them in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. So I want you to think about that for a minute. Now let's think of all these things that we have up there. How many of you guys are going away for Christmas? How many are going on a vacation? Bet you're excited about that, right? How many are excited about Santa coming? Yeah, a lot of you, right? How many are excited about a new gaming system or maybe spending time playing video games this Christmas break? How many of you are excited about maybe getting a new phone? Yeah. How about new clothes? Are you excited about new clothes? Any of you guys excited about the Elf on the Shelf and what? Yeah, a lot of you, right? How about football? How about sporting goods stuff, sports equipment? You excited about that? Probably none of us excited for the Bears game on Christmas Eve, though, huh? How about shoes? Who's excited about getting a new pair of shoes? Yeah. So these things are all good things. They're all nice things. They're all blessings. But the question that I have is, have we forgotten Jesus this Christmas season? Do we have a place for Jesus in our Christmas celebration? Yeah. You know, I go to the store. When I go to the store and I walk around the store and go shopping, I don't see much about Jesus. I see maybe a few cards But I look all around, I see Santa, I see elves, I see Christmas trees and Christmas lights, but I don't see anything about Jesus. Now I watch a football game or the basketball game on TV and I see the commercials, and I don't see anything about Jesus. See commercial after commercial, but I realize there's no place for Jesus in the stores. And there's no place for Jesus on the TV. I wonder, is there room in your home for Jesus? Is there room in my home for Jesus? Is there room in our hearts for Jesus this Christmas season? I'm going to ask you a question. Have you ever been left out by your friends or your classmates? Yeah. Maybe by your big brother or your big sister. Have you ever not been invited to somebody's birthday party? I have. I remember back, I was like 11 or 12 years old, and Joanna P., and I'm not going to say her last name, but she invited everybody to her birthday party except for me and a couple other people, and I felt pretty left out. You ever felt that way? Yeah, that Joanna P. But what if you or I didn't get invited? What if we didn't get invited to our own birthday party? Wouldn't that be awful if you didn't get invited to your own birthday party? But that's what people do on Christmas. Do you know that? Christmas is Jesus' birthday party. It's the time we celebrate. So here we have all this Christmas stuff, all these Christmas gifts, Christmas trips. We have Santa, we have elves on shelves, and all these other things. All these gifts. And we have all this merchandise that's sold, and all these stores make tons and tons of money and everything else. And you know what? We have no place for Jesus at Christmas. And guess what? It's his birthday. It's his birthday. So all these other things, the vacations, the Santa, the games, video games, the phones, the clothes, the elves, the sporting goods and football games and gym shoes and all these things are great. But Christmas is about Jesus. It's about Jesus first and foremost. And yet, it looks like when we go to stores and we watch the commercials, like he hasn't been invited to his own birthday party. Now, do you realize that all these things, right? All these things, none of them compare to Jesus. He is the greatest gift of Christmas. He has no rival. Christmas is about Jesus. Do you know Jesus? He is Emmanuel. You know what Emmanuel means? It means God with us. Yeah, God with us. He left the beauty and the glory of heaven to come down to earth to rescue you and me. I think about it. We go on vacation. We go to nice places, beautiful places during Christmas time. But Jesus left the most beautiful place to come to rescue us during, and that's what we celebrate at Christmas. He came to save you and me from our sins, from all the bad things we did, so that we could go to heaven, so we could go to that most beautiful place. Jesus was there being worshipped by the angels and left to come down to earth so that he could die for our sins, buried on the third day, rise again, so that we could be saved, so that we could be rescued. He came to die in our place and rise from the dead. God the Son left heaven where the angels worshiped him. He was born as a baby. He became like us to save us from our sin. So what should we do about it this Christmas season? What should we do about it? Well, we need to make room for him. There was no room for him in the inn. But we need to make room for Jesus. We need to recognize he's the King of Kings. We need to worship him. Christmas is about his birthday. Will you enjoy all these other things that you're blessed with? Recognize that Christmas is first and foremost about who? Jesus. Jesus. He's what's most important. Tell Jesus, I want you in my home. I want you in my life. I want you in my heart. I want you in my head. Think about Jesus this Christmas season. Sing songs to him. Read about him in the Bible. Tell your mom and dads on Christmas morning before you open up any presents, I want to hear that story about Jesus and how he was born. Tell others about the real reason for Christmas, Jesus. The angels told the shepherds taking care of their sheep, this is what they said to him. They said, today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Right? He was in the manger because there was no room for him in the inn. So when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about. So they hurried off and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger, the baby Jesus. Know what those shepherds did? They heard what the angels told them. And more than anything else, you know who they wanted to see? Jesus. And just like Caleb and Hudson, you saw them run across that stage. Those shepherds, they ran to Bethlehem to go and see Jesus. And when they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. The shepherds went to Jesus on that first Christmas. Go to Jesus. Worship him. Without Jesus, there's no Christmas. With him, there's joy like no other. Like the song says, joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her king. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. Let's pray. Lord God, I pray that you bless every child, every teacher, every staff member, every parent, every family member this Christmas. I pray that they recognize that the Lord Jesus Christ is the greatest of all blessings this Christmas. That they would recognize that no other blessing compares to him. I pray that they may see him, that they may know him, and that they may rejoice with hearts full of gratitude as they remember what Jesus has done for them. We thank you for Jesus, Lord, and we pray this all in his mighty and wonderful name, in the name of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, who left heaven to rescue us from our sin. It's in his wonderful and mighty name we pray, in Jesus' name, amen.
Please stand and worship with us.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come.
All right, let's give up for our fifth graders. Thank you so much for leading us. Thank you to Mrs. Volpe and Mrs. Westenberg and all their guidance in leading them in all their worship song. Thank you, Pastor Volpe, for your great message on Christmas and what we need to keep in our hearts during this time of the year. Well, you guys all, thank you for all our visitors today. You guys have an awesome, awesome Christmas break, and make sure that you're focusing on the true meaning of what it's really all about. Fifth grade parents, well, kids are already here, ready to be photographed, I guess. So well, well done. So thank you again. Have an awesome Christmas and Happy New Year to everybody, and you guys are dismissed.